because the Patrick and the Murray administration has actually weakened the proposed rules for biomass regulations. And biomass sounds green to people, but it's actually something that's worse than fossil fuels. The first question is, why are they even giving any subsidies to something dirtier than fossil fuels? It's not green. Burning trees is not green. But at least the first step would be to put in place some real regulations to make sure we're not subsidizing something that's going to make things worse. And what happened was, before the election, the administration released some rules on paper that would have made some protections for our forests, for our air, and for carbon dioxide emissions. After the election, they caved to the biomass and the timber industries, and they ended up weakening these regulations so much that we're actually going to have taxpayers subsidizing basically burning forests and calling it green energy when it's in fact worse than just about any other source of energy. So we're here to say, honor your promises, strengthen the regulations, go back to the requirements you had originally, and stand up for the public and not just the profits of the developer, the biomass. As a public, for each plant, $10 to $15 million a year, every year, for something that's making our air worse, more carbon emissions, and threatening our forest efficiency. If they build all these biomass plants, they have five proposed, if they build them all, you literally have to increase logging about 300% in Massachusetts. You get 1% more power. Just for 1% more power, we're going to torch our forests. So it's really crazy, and we're subsidizing that. Instead, we should be subsidizing something like solar, where you can employ a lot of people putting these up on the roofs, and you're actually improving the situation.
There's a in Greenfield, there's a 47 megawatt power plant proposed for right in Greenfield, right in a residential area, and that particular one would be slated to burn 600,000 tons of wood every year and operate at 23% efficiency. So while we were opposing that project in Greenfield, we managed to get a vote of the town on one particular issue. It didn't stop the power plant, but on a question that was related to it, and we won 84% of the vote. So just in Greenfield and in Franklin County, people have had a lot of time to look at the issues because it's being proposed there, and people are very much against it.
In fact, I think we might have a little bit of a shell game going on. Are we getting science? Are we getting politics? Or are we going to end up with nothing at all? Science says that we can achieve 80% efficiency. That's what they're doing in Europe with biomass energy. Our Green Communities Act, passed here in this building, says that we can achieve 60% efficiency. What are we getting? 40% or less. That's not acceptable. Science says that we should not be removing any more trees from the forest or residues from the forest than 15% of the tops and branches of the trees. And we certainly should not be cutting down old trees and burning them at the rate of 1 ton a minute per megawatt. And what are we getting? Almost 40% of these trees could be removed in Massachusetts under the proposed regulations. That doesn't sound like a good deal to me. And science says, most importantly, that climate change is the reigning challenge of our time. And we need to ratchet down our greenhouse gas emissions. At this time, we need to do it now. We need to start immediately, and we need to bring them down as quickly as possible. The Green Communities Act, the Global Warming Solutions Act, all call for measures for renewable energy solutions that will bring these greenhouse gas emissions down. The Global Warming Solutions Act is calling for massive reductions by 2025, even higher reductions by 2050. What are we going to get in this deal here instead? We're going to turn on biomass plants, and we're going to ratchet up our greenhouse gas emissions, because the greenhouse gas emissions from a biomass plant are 50% worse than even the worst coal plants that we have in our region. Not acceptable. I think we need to tell the governor and the legislature and all the legislators that are here today that have stepped up and written letters to the governor. We'll be acknowledging those folks in a little bit and all the groups that are standing behind here at the end. We need to tell them that we want stronger regulations. We need to stick to the arrangement that was made last year when these regulations were first proposed, when they were tracked carefully to science, not to politics, and weren't beaten by industry. Industry has had a hand in these regulations. Let's put them back where they belong, and you're going to hear a lot from other folks today about what's wrong with these regulations and how we can fix and make them better.
not know where Greenfield is, it's 2 hours straight west on Route 2. It's a very wonderful community, and about 2 years ago we were faced with the prospect of a 50 megawatt wood burning biomass incinerator in the middle of our community, and believe me, these people have worked hard and long to try to support these changes in the law as well as on the local level, working to change some of their local politics as well. So it has been a long struggle and a long fight, and we not only have the people from Greenfield here today, but we have 120,000 Massachusetts voters across the state who signed petitions to get the question on the ballot in 2009 and 2010. We have another 5,000 signatures that we've collected since then that we will be delivering to the governor. So the people have invested their blood, sweat, and tears in fighting on these issues since at least 2005. We're still petitioning 2 years later.
Thank you very much. Go ahead, and we also have 7,000 petitions that have been signed by residents and voters in Massachusetts over the last year. 5,000 petitions to add to the 120,000 that we collected in 2009 and 2010. So two petitions are here, including Amanda from Greenfield and Wendy.
Yep.
Hey, Amanda.
Can you get this man over here?
Hi, Amanda. How are you? Are those for me? Thank you very much.
You're going to need kind of a little bit of a hand here,
okay,
because we have a lot of them for you. Do some more.
Thank you.
We had several thousand signatures that we delivered to the governor's office today to protest biomass energy. And we're protesting biomass energy because it's a dirty, polluting form of energy, and we don't want it to be subsidized by ratepayer subsidies or any other kinds of tax incentives or any other incentives at the federal level that would promote energy as green when it really isn't. These plants consume massive quantities of trees. They have massive greenhouse gas emissions. They have massive impacts on forest ecosystems because of the destruction that they cause and the volume that they consume just to generate electricity. And in Massachusetts, if all the plants were built, it still wouldn't provide even 1% of the electricity that we need in Massachusetts. So it's not worth going out and devastating thousands of acres of trees just to provide a small incremental part of Massachusetts electricity. And I think importantly, we just don't want to have taxpayers and ratepayers funding that kind of green energy when it's actually destroying the environment and worsening climate change. 75 to 100 people today here in Nurses Hall at the State House, citizens from all around the Commonwealth, came out to deliver a message to the governor. And we had hundreds of thousands of citizens sign ballot question petitions last year to try and ask the state to strengthen its biomass regulations. So we have well over 120,000 citizens of the Commonwealth that are calling on the governor to strengthen the proposed regulations. And we'd be the first in the nation to take this step. There are other countries in the world that have already taken this step to try and reduce these incentives for polluting dirty biomass that devastates forests. But we would be the first state in America to actually try and make a correction based on the new science, knowing that this is polluting and increases greenhouse gas emissions. Well, the fact is that many other industries related to the timber industry are actually stepping up, and they're opposing biomass because they're worried about their jobs. Because what will happen is if we promote biomass, it's going to gobble up all the residual wood in the forests. And that wood is used in plywood and other kinds of products that the wood actually gets made into. Some of it's used in the paper and pulp industries. And instead, we're just going to dump this into a furnace and burn it in a few seconds for a very incremental portion of its energy. Other industries that have jobs are stepping up and saying, we don't want the biomass industry to gobble up all these jobs that are actually going to take jobs away from us. And there's more jobs in efficiency, and there's more jobs in recycling than promoting burning forests for electricity. There's a number of places they can go to learn more about the issue. They can even sign online petitions at these websites. They can go to stopspewingcarbon.org. They can go to our website for the Sierra Club, which is sierraclubmass.org, and you can learn all about the destructive practices of this industry and why they want the incentives from ratepayers to promote their industry when they're not really green. You can learn about why we're objecting to giving them green renewable energy credits when they're actually going to be cutting down and destroying forests and burning them at very inefficient rates, pumping lots of carbon into the atmosphere. It doesn't sound very green or renewable.